Hi, welcome to this question right here. So what happened is we're trying to determine the dimension of this cutout piece. So we got a little rectangle right here, right? So we got all sorts of information down here. So we're going to use each pieces right here to determine the dimension of this part that you're going to cut out, which is this part right here, okay? So let's start from the top first. So if you're looking from the top, it says right over here on the back over here is 20. So I'm going to put a little 20 right there to remind ourselves. And this part right here, this part here is 15, so that's 15. Okay, so this is going to add it in. So far, there isn't too much information that we have to determine the dimension of that little cutout piece. Let's go to the next one. Let's look at it from the left. So this is your left-hand side, this piece right here. That's your left-hand side. So it says, if you're looking from the left, this part right here is 6 centimeters, so that's 6. So we just discovered our first dimension of the cutout piece. This bottom part right here is 6, okay? And then we have nothing else, okay? That's unfortunately. But we do know that 20, that's 20, that's 6, so that makes this part here 14, okay? I don't know if we need that, but let's just put it in just in case we need it for later questions. Let's look at from the front. If you're looking from the front, you're looking from this way, okay? So we have the 20, oh, this side is also 20, okay? So let's zoom in, put a little line right there to represent that that side is 20. And we know that the bottom part is 27. That's your 27. Oh, we do know the next dimension now because it looks like actually we do. Yeah, because that's 10 right there. See this part right here, the 10? It just means this part here is also 10. Okay? Kind of ran out of space. But if you just do a quick math right there, this whole thing is 20, right? And that part is 10. So that makes this part here is 10 as well. Okay? And that part represents this part here. So we just found out our next dimension, which is this part. That's 10. This is also 10. Okay? So the only thing that we're missing is actually, oh shoot, it's not missing. It's actually, we know this whole thing is 27, right? Now, if you take that 27 and subtract the 15 on the top, you get yourself just the 12. Okay? And that 12 will go right there. So we just figure out our last dimension right here, which is 12. Okay? So it's 6 times 12 times 10 for this cutout piece. And if you want to figure out the area right now, 6 times 12 times the 10, we get our area, turns out to be, just let me follow the work here, which is length times the width times the height, right? So we got ourselves 6 times the 12 times the 10, we have 720, okay? So that 720 is the area, and the dimension for this question is 6 times 10 times the 12. And then let's quickly go to the next question and see what they're asking for. They're looking for, just let me switch, so remember it. We still have the dimension of 720, right? But as you can see, the next question says, how does the surface area of the original rectangle object change after cutting out that corner piece? Well, this question here doesn't really need the calculation. Because if you think about it, the surface area did not change at all, okay? So the answer to that question right now, I would just say there's no change. Now you're probably thinking like, okay, how is that possible? Because you cut out one piece from that original rectangle, right? This piece is being cut out. But surface area is different from the volume. Surface area is when you look at an object from all the surfaces, right? So if you just imagine, if you're looking at this cutout pieces right now, not the cutout piece, this diagram right here with all these dimensions, if you're looking from the top, you still see a perfect rectangle. If you're looking from the left, it is still a perfect rectangle. And if you see it from the right, which is still a rectangle, right? And what you're seeing right here is the same as before, okay? Because when you're looking from, let's say if you're looking from the top, you still see the surface, let me just erase all this right here. You still see all this surface area, including that little piece down here. So the surface area actually didn't change from before and after. So that's why the surface area of the original rectangle object, it did not change even after you cut it out, okay? Only the volume changes, okay? Hopefully that makes sense. Thanks for watching.